today I have a what's in my gym bag video. I already did a video like this almost 2 years ago, but since I have a new gym bag and since it always changes what I keep in there, I thought I would do an updated video for you guys. And also, if you stay tuned until the end of this video, I'm gonna show you my favorite post-workout vegan protein smoothie. So I wish you guys lots of fun watching. So this is the gym bag I'm currently using. It's by the brand Fabletics. They sent me this for Christmas and I was super excited about it because I saw it on their website earlier and I think this bag is so pretty. I love the color and especially the fabric. Here in the front it has a zipper pocket which I like to use for my house key, and on the back there's another pocket. On the inside there is a lot of space and it has three side pockets on one side and on the other side is a zipper pocket. So of course one of the most important things to bring to the gym is your gym outfit if you aren't wearing it already. I usually put it on before I go to the gym, but just for the sake of this video I'm gonna show it now. So of course I'll wear some type of sports bra. This one is by H&M. I've shown this one in one of my monthly favorites videos because I think it's a really great sports bra and it costs only 15 euros. I also like to wear gym socks because for one they are way more comfortable than regular socks. They are great for any type of workout because they prevent you from getting any blisters on your feet because the fabric is thicker in certain areas. For my workouts, I prefer wearing these leggings, you know, just regular black leggings, also from Fabletics. If you ever wondered why people wear tight clothes for their workouts, definitely check out my blog post on this. It's about fitness, compression clothes, and what's the point of wearing it. My gym top is usually just a cotton top. I don't know, I like it a little bit looser around the top. This one is also by Fabletics, and I'm just gonna show you a picture from my Instagram because it's kind of hard to show this on camera because it has this really nice detail on the back. And I always bring some sort of jacket for my way to the gym and also back home from the gym because right after working out I usually get really cold, so it's nice to have some extra layers to put on. I also bring a towel. I use this one to put on the machines, and if I need something to dry my face off then I'll just grab some of the paper towels they have at the gym because I don't want to put something on my face that might have a lot of bacteria on it, so I think it's safest to just use paper towels. Now during the winter time I also bring a little beanie. This one is also from Fabletics and I keep this in my bag just in case I forgot to bring one and I'm on my way home and I have like sweaty hair and it's a little bit moist. It's definitely not a good idea to not have anything on because you could possibly catch a cold. Of course I also have gym shoes. I've had these for a couple of years now. I got these really cheap at a discount supermarket for only 20 euros, but they're very comfortable and I like the color. Next up is my water bottle. This one is actually a shaker because on the inside it has this little metal ball that helps to dissolve any sort of powder you put in there. So I will fill this one up with water and then I add a scoop of the One Amino by Fitness Guru. This is a amino acid powder and it has like all of the essential amino acids you need during your workout. I also like to bring my makeup bag to the gym, so this is the one I usually keep in my purse and if I go to the gym I'll just put it in there. In here I just keep a few basic things like a mineral powder or a lip balm. This is just for when I go somewhere after the gym, like to the supermarket to buy a few groceries. Of course I don't want to look super greasy then, so I'll just put a little bit of powder on and I'm good to go. I also keep face wipes in my gym bag. These are just regular face wipes from the German drugstore DM. If you're prone to getting pimples and little breakouts, it definitely helps to keep a clean face, especially after you've been sweating a lot. So once I'm done, I'll either wash my face with water or I'll just use a face wipe. And this is also great if you're going to the gym and you're still wearing makeup for some reason, then you can take it off with this. And for that same reason, I also like to bring a tiny jar of coconut oil. This is empty at the moment because I just washed it, but in here I just keep regular coconut oil because it's so versatile and you can use it for many things. So you can use it as a moisturizer, you can also use it to take off your makeup, even waterproof makeup, and I also like to use it as a hair mask. So sometimes while I'm in the gym I will actually put a lot of coconut oil in my hair and on the top of my head and kind of let that soak in, because once I'm done I will take a shower and wash my hair anyways. So I like to use this time to do a hair mask. I also bring a phone holder type of thing. I'm not sure what you would call it. I just put my phone in here, and then there's this strap that goes around your arm. So I use this to listen to my music. This is perfect if you have all of your music on your phone. It's not ideal because then you have your phone in the gym, and then if someone calls or you get a text message, you're so much more likely to get distracted and look at your phone. But I really try just to use it for my music. And of course, I also bring my headphones, and these are the regular ones that came with my Samsung Galaxy. And I like these because they have the volume setting right here. Of course, I also want to smell nice in the gym, so I bring a deodorant. This one is by the brand CD, and it has a very fresh, clean, and soap-like scent. And then I also bring a body splash, and this one is by The Body Shop, and it smells like cranberries, and it's a really sweet scent. I think the person next to me really appreciates it if I smell like this rather than like sweat. I also like to bring some type of food for after the gym, so these are two cereal bars. Those are just regular cereal bars from a cheap brand. I like to bring them in case I get really hungry after the gym, so I'll just eat these on the way. I don't buy protein bars just because I think they're really expensive. You pay almost 2 or 3 euros for a protein bar, and since I do my protein shake at home anyways, I'll just have some type of carbs for the way home, and then I'll do the protein shake when I get home. All right, and finally, here in the zipper pocket, I just like to keep little things I don't need all the time, but just in case of an emergency, like for example, eye drops, because I wear contacts in the gym. So sometimes if you get dry eyes or you have something in there, it's good to have eye drops, gum if I have bad breath for some reason, paper tissues, and also 2 hair ties in case I forgot to bring one. So these were all of the contents of my gym bag. If you're interested in this gym bag, I will definitely link it in the info box. And now I'm going to show you my favorite post-workout vegan protein smoothie. Smoothie. If you should give it a try, definitely let me know how you liked it. Thank you very much for watching today's video. I wish you all a wonderful week, and then I'll see you in my next video. Bye!